Okay, how did you decide to make it the DVD of Hypocrisy here in Bulgaria?
It's because when we were here with Pain last time, it was totally insane, you know. So we said, like, we need to do a DVD, and so we said, let's go back to Bulgaria, because that's where the crazy people are, you know. And they're so loud, and it's got everything you need, you know. And the venue is very good, and so it's a perfect thing.
And what are your future plans after the DVD?
I'm gonna be home for a little bit. We're gonna go to Russia. We're gonna do like 4 gigs in Sweden, and then we're gonna fly over to America in May. So it will be pretty busy for a while, and plus I'm gonna start writing some more material for, I don't know if it's gonna be Hypocrisy or Pain. It all depends what kind of mood I'm in, you know.
And how did you create Hypocrisy back in 1990?
I don't know, I guess the same way as I did with Pain, you know, me sitting home with the Porta studio and just writing material and stuff like that, and then try to put people together to actually get it out on the CD and stuff like that. So, I mean, everything is, for me with the Hypocrisy, it was all about, you know, being influenced by other bands, you know, definitely, you know, DSI, Morbid Angel, Entombed and stuff, you know.
And black metal from Venom, Evil Invaders from Razor, Black Magic from Slayer.
Yeah.
How do you choose the songs to cover?
I don't know. You know when you have hear a good song, you know, you know it in your heart, and those are the ones that, you know, means a lot for us in the band, you know. So okay. It's just an influence.
And why did you remake the album Catch 22?
Because, you know, when it came out 2002, people were like, "What the fuck," you know. And but I guess people didn't expect it at the time, you know. And after a while, actually, why I redid it, it was more or less like I was changing my computer and stuff like that, and I had Catch 22 in there, you know, with the files and stuff. And I started remixing, and because I had to try my computer, and then I realized, okay, maybe it wasn't so good sound as it could be, you know. So then I started changing the drum sound and stuff like that, just for myself, because checking everything, you know. And then all of a sudden I was like, ooh, that sounds better than the original. And then I remember everybody was complaining about it, and then so I did the new vocals on it, to put it more in the growling way. And yeah, it was kind of funny, because when that one came out a couple of years ago, then people, like, who was complaining when the original came out, they were like, why did you do that, you know, the old one was good, you know. So, but it doesn't matter, you know. The only thing I did it was because to please those who didn't like it, you know. It was not easy money making, you know. It was more or less, you know, if you don't like the old one, check this new one out. If you like the old one, don't get the new one.
And Valley of the Damned is the most popular song of Hypocrisy in Last FM. What's the history of that song?
I don't know, very Slayer influenced song, you know. And I don't know, it's, you know, Slayer is Slayer, and, you know, it's a very big influence for 95% of all the metal bands, I think, you know. And it's just the tempo of the song, the aggression and stuff, you know. It's, for me, it's really good.
And the most popular song of Pain is Shut Your Mouth at the Last FM. How did you make this song?
Well, it was a very fast procedure, you know. I had the melody in my head when I was laying down, and I ran down to the studio and recorded it, you know, and then went back up to bed, you know, and next morning I finished it off, you know. So sometimes simple is better, you know. Mm-hmm.
And the history of Follow Me?
I don't know. It's hard to say why and how, and it's more like the lyrics on that song is just my bad luck, you know, sometimes, you know, follow me and we all go to hell, shit goes wrong and so on, you know. I mean, for me it's a very simple song, you know, it's catchy, and mm-hmm. Yeah, the lyrics are definitely about my life, you know, that's and bad lucks, but I think it's turning.
And may we expect soon a new album from Pain?
I think so, yeah. I mean, right now I really don't know what I'm gonna write when I come home, you know. If I'm in the mood for death metal, then I'm gonna start writing some songs for Hippo. If I'm in a different mood, then I'm gonna write some songs for Pain, you know. I mean, even though if the next album's gonna be a Pain album, I'm still gonna write Hypocrisy stuff, you know, so it's not that I turn off the death metal and turn on the Pain stuff, you know, it's just the way it works for me, you know, it all depends on my mood. You know?
Okay, and where do you find the inspiration for your songs and lyrics?
I don't know, life, I guess.
And that's the place you may tell something special to your fans here in Bulgaria and to the readers of Metal Hanger 18th.
Yeah, hey, you guys kick ass. That's why we're here, and it's gonna be fucking great.
Okay, thank you.
Thank
very
you
much.
Very much.